30th October 2018, I was felt deeply hurt because after going through his teaching and then a new revival of the spiritual movement in India, I personally found that whatever teachings and whatever the books he has written, he has given to the society, I deeply felt sad when I came to know that the man who has revived the spiritual movement in India had been deep impact not only in India but also in the worldwide. When I heard about his demise on 30th October, I was in Bodhgaya. I was coming from there. So I was thinking like when I was there in the land of movement, which I usually said about Bodhgaya, Buddha has created a huge impact in whole universe. When Bhante came here and then he founded the new spiritual movement in India, he has given the new alternatives in the spiritual movement. National Network of Buddhist Youth, when we started in 2006-07, I found that many of the spiritual teachings and trainings we got, we mostly got from the various Dhammacharis and Dhammacharinis, and that too from the movement of the movement which has given by Bhante Bhagavan Sarvakshita. So I really say thank you to Bhante that he has given the new movement in the spiritual movement in India. When I was thinking since 30th October till now, 13 days has been passed through this. Today at, in the evening, his final funeral procession will be there. When I was thinking of NNBY, I was thinking that we have started the national the youth movement, whose total based we should be based on the principle of Lord Buddha and Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar and various other social revolutionary people ideology. But when I was thinking of that Bhante on this 10th November 2018, we are paying the rich tribute to Bhante. We are not paying to the rich tribute, only rich tribute to Bhante. Basically, we are determining ourselves that when he left, he was at a he has given his lifespan of 93 years to this movement. And NNBY, when NNBY has started this movement, we were thinking of like on 10th November 2018. Will just not pay the rich tribute to Bhante, but whatever the teachings he has given to a movement, that revival of the teaching and the revival of the trainings, whatever he has been expected from our whole world, that this youth movement will spread in the spiritual movement. This is what I am thinking since last 13 days. Past 13 days, it was very difficult for us that how we are thinking, like how we will put it in the practical form. He has written so many books and he has given so many teachings and trainings and given talks. But I am finding that in the whole India, he was also a good writer. But it's not the movement of good writings and good teachings, but it's the methods and the application of the spiritual movement, how this, what the theory he has given, how it will be applying the methods and the applications, that is very important, which I am personally thinking. This new generation should revive these things, not only in the form of only the theoretical form, but apart from theoretical, how it, the movement which the Buddha has given to us, and he is just the medium towards the, he's given, he's been the meme and the medium for this movement, the movement which has been given by Lord Buddha. So I personally feel that the overall youth in India, which we consider that they have many big spark in them. So that spark, through the movement of National Network of Buddhist Youth, I strongly feel that it will be the rich tribute if all the youths in the movement will just not read the books, but how to apply those theory in the field, that is more challenging in coming years. So in this date of 10th November 2018, I personally feel that I personally reminded myself that in 1956, Dr. Ambedkar left to us by giving us a beautiful Dhamma to us. And he not only changed himself, but he has changed the lives of the millions of peoples in our world. Likewise, the Bhante, what he has learned from Dr. Ambedkar and the Buddha, he tried to give that Dhamma in the new form to the world. I personally feel that whatever he has imbibed from Dr. Ambedkar, that prayer, that application should be, that he has apply all those things what Dr. Ambedkar has was thinking in his lifespan. Likewise, we from on the behalf of National Network of Buddhist Youth, we are working in many states in India. We would like to pay our rich tributes to Bhante by doing the practical work in the field, whatever he has taught to us. Bhante ko zyada maine padha nahi aur zyada maine shibir nahi kiya, lekin 10 saal se jo Subhuti Kumar ji aur inke sanidhya mein rehkar Anamshur Anambun ke sath mein rehkar jo baatein sikha maine, वो बातें बहुत इंपॉर्टेंटली लग रही है मुझे कि प्रैक्टिकल हम लोगों ने जो डिस्कशन में जो सीखा अपन ने, जो डिस्कशन से बहुत सारी बातें हमने ज़्यादा सीखी है, लेकिन थियोरेटिकल हमने इतना नहीं पढ़ा उनको, लेकिन एक डिस्कशन में भी मुझे लगता है कि बचपन से जैसे अनुमशूर के साथ में मैंने इतने दिनों से देखा कि अनुमशूर उनकी पैदाइशी संघ में हुई, यानी मूवमेंट में ही उनका ये हुआ। अनुमगुन भी काफ़ी साल तक उन्होंने ही रहे, तो हमारे जो मित्र है, ये लोग हमारे जो मित्र थे, इन्होंने बचपन से ही ये सब देखा है, मिला है उनको धरोहर से। तो व्हाट आई फील इज पर्सनली टू इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग विच आई केम टू नोटिस विच आई फॉरगेट टू टेल यू गाइस, द फॉरमोस्ट थिंग इज दैट व्हेन आई वाज इन बोधगया रिसेंटली, देयर आई केम टू नो फ्रॉम सम ऑफ आवर गाइस दैट अशोका हैज ब्रॉट दिस मूवमेंट, दिस बुद्धिस्ट मूवमेंट in his kingdom, and Ashoka is the greatest example through which the movement has been revived in a very different form, in a very dynamic and very rational form. When Ashoka can do that thing, apply in his kingdom the principle of Buddhism, the Buddhist principle which is totally scientific and rational and not only spiritual. But in the context of recently what Sanju Dada has mentioned about the spiritual, economic, political and various dimension and perspective. So why I want to connote these things with the movement of Bhante is that when I remember the various different teachings which Bhante has given to us, so it is not the only one perspective of the spiritual movement. It is not the only one. It, apart from that, there are very dimensions which Bhante has dreamt for, and the Bhante which dreamt for is not only in the perspective of spiritual aspect, which our people in Indian context our people has taken up, but I personally feel is that in the context of the application of Buddhism, apart from that, there are the different perspective like the social aspect, the economic aspects, which is very much imbibed by Bhante, and till now the movement has been survived on the economic basis. So that has to be learned from the teachings of Bhante. That is for the most important thing which I came to know. Apart from that, the spreading of the education movement which Bhante has given to us, not only in the form of the writing and the speech theory, but whatever he has written in the various vast subjects, in the different fora he has written. He has given the talks on the different fora. So what I personally feel is that as a youth organization of NMBY, we should learn two things from the movement of the Bhante, is that he has also mentioned many times of the various stupa and the 84,000 stupa of Ashoka has developed. The thing is that what Ashoka has given to us, the Ashoka can do that one. Why not in 21st century the youth movement has it, when we have such a wonderful teaching given by Bhante. So in the different perspective what has given by Bhante, I personally thank you to Bhante in one context, that he is not only the man of the spiritual movement, but he is an institution itself. And that institution itself has given the greatest example, put for the greater example before the whole world. So as it doesn't matter what he has started the movement in the with the people help of the people of hippie people and all that. That hippie people is a different people. They had started that movement. We are thankful to them. But back in India, when we see that the movement has been struggled with the greatest disease nowhere you find in the world. That is only the greatest disease of caste which we can see in India. So if the strong Dhamma is with us, and how to apply that Dhamma in the various parameters of social, political, economic situation, there with the basis of Dhamma, that is a big challenge before the youth movement in India. So I personally feel is that that is the two things which I personally felt that I left, and that is what I want to communicate. Thank you.